What's up, people? It's your girl, Adeola. Do you know that 15 million people are ready to leave Nigeria for America? No, seriously, 15 million people. Ah, I see. Now, wow. They're ready to leave Nigeria to go to America. That's according to a recent survey by Gallup. Gallup is a research-based consulting company. Now, you know, I don't blame these people that want to leave Nigeria. I don't blame them. If you just think about up Nepa, down Nepa, or if you just think about, you know, the bombings that have become an everyday occurrence, it's like, why wouldn't people want to leave now? And, you know, we have Nigerians in every country of the world. I don't believe there's a country where you will not find a Nigerian, at least. You know, Nigerians are in South Sudan. Yes, they are in South Sudan, trying to make ends meet. No offense to South Sudan, but, you know, it's like, looking for green pastures, you go to South Sudan. Nigerians are even in Siberia. That's one of the coldest places on earth. And of course, Nigeria keeps losing a lot of, you know, young professionals, people that went overseas to study. A lot of them are not going back to Nigeria because it's like each time they go to Nigeria, electricity is still not stable. We yet to take care of the basic things, the roads, water, and electricity. And of course, security issues, you know. So having said all that, I like to keep it real. So I like it when people travel to other countries or when you move to live in another country because it's life-changing. It's a great experience. If you have the opportunity, please travel to another country, experience life elsewhere, learning about other cultures, other languages. But my own thing is, my fellow brothers and sisters, don't be too desperate to leave Nigeria, especially if you have a good job, okay? Please, don't be too quick to quit your job to move to America. Because life in America ain't that easy, to say the truth. If you have the money, you can create your own America in Nigeria. If you must go visit the place where you're going and see how life is there before you quit your job and move. So honestly, sometimes, you know, the grass looks greener on the other side, but it may not be as green when you get there, especially if you go there without a green card. You will have to do daytime, nighttime, and part-time job just to survive. Speaking of green cards, they just released the result of the green card lottery. So starting from May 1st, you can check to know if you're one of the winners. They just said they will release more names in October. So if you didn't win, just check back in October. You never know, you may win in October. And if you win, please bring your wife, bring your husband one time. Don't think that you can come here and send for them the following month because it could take years for them to get their visas. I'm just keeping it real. That reminds me of a new video by Deji Badamosi of Channels TV. He revealed that about 1,000 Nigerians are imprisoned in China. Many of these guys were arrested for drug-related issues. Some of these guys may be innocent, but the language barrier is making it hard for them to fight for their rights. Some of them have been jailed up to 15 years. Some of them were actually given lifetime imprisonment. Meanwhile, many of their family members in Nigeria have no clue what's going on in China. And those who call home to tell them that they've been arrested, they only told their families that they were arrested for paper issues, like the husbands of these women.
Not some people have said that he's dead. You know, a lot of rumors. But I keep on believing God. So after 2008, he called me, he told me that he's not dead, that he has a problem over there. That I asked him what kind of problem. He said that he's having a problem in his papers.
But this document containing the names of Nigerians doing time in jails across China and given to us by a government source who would not want his identity disclosed because he's not authorized to speak to the media, revealed Mr. Dike lied to his wife about the nature of his problem in China. He is currently serving a life sentence in Huzhou prison for drug smuggling.
Who am I going to tell the children? What will I tell the children? Even the twins, they don't know their daddy. What will I tell them? They called me and said, my husband is here. I said, who? My husband from where? He says, from China. I said, give him phone. He said, no, they cannot give him phone. But let me speak. If anything I talk, he will hear me.
Another woman with virtually the same story. Charity Okoro, a mother of four.
These guys in prison are living on less than $5 a month. Many of them are saying that they only give them watered rice for the whole day. So a lot of them are dying in prison, and their family members are hoping that the Nigerian government can help to bring them to Nigeria, you know, to serve their terms. Kenya has decided to be paying off their politicians so that they can stay out of politics as soon as their terms are over. So when President Kibaki walks out of the state house after the next election, he will be leaving with 50 million shillings. That's like $600,000. Kenyan officials are saying that this is a way of thanking them for all their hard works when in office. I think they're just, you know, bribing them. It's just like giving them lollipop and saying, don't come back, oh, don't come back to run for presidency. If it's not a bribe, you know, how come he's also getting four cars of his choice, four brand new cars of his choice with fuel allowance? Not just that, full medical coverage, including going overseas for treatment, huh? The country will be paying for all of that, okay? And he'll be getting a fully furnished office. I don't know what for, considering the fact that he's retiring. I don't know why he needs a brand new office. But the best part is, it's getting up to 38 servants. Yes, and the country will be paying their salaries. Yes, of course, this includes 6 bodyguards, 2 personal assistants, 4 drivers, 4 messengers, 2 cooks, 2 housekeepers, 2 gardeners, 2 laundry people, 4 people to keep his house clean, a younger wife, a brand new, sorry, I just said a younger wife, that is a slip of tongue. Lucy will never allow that. Hey, a younger wife for the president of Kenya? No way. No way. So that is just a slip of tongue, yes. But he's getting everything else that I have listed. See why I said it is a lollipop, just to make sure that they don't come back to say they want to run for presidency. I'm just keeping it real. Thumbs up this week goes to 2 countries, actually. The first one is Angola. Angola now has high-speed 4G internet that beats most European countries. Yep, how cool is that? You know, Angola has made a lot of progress in rebuilding its economy, and now it is the second biggest oil producer in Africa. Also, the economic growth has led to infrastructural development. So now you will see a lot of new skyscrapers and glass doors in cities in Angola. The second country that got the thumbs up this week is South Africa. 600 police officers were recently arrested in South Africa for corruption charges. This means we're taking bribes and tips from the people, and you know, it is against the law. I just wish more African countries will do this, arresting policemen that are taking bribes. The thumbs down this week goes to Nigeria for getting a nasty letter from Transparency International. Transparency International is the organization that releases the corruption index of each country every year. They tell you which country is the most corrupt and which one is the least corrupt. And actually, Olusegun Obasanjo is one of the co-founders of Transparency International. So they sent a really nasty letter to the president of Nigeria. Actually, I don't know how authentic the letter is, but you know. Yes, it's been circulating, you know, in so many newspapers, so I'm not sure how authentic it is, but it's been circulating everywhere, and I thought I should let you know about this letter, okay? So the letter basically complained that they've never seen the level of corruption that they are seeing in Nigeria, that they don't know how to deal with it. They're saying that their workers in Nigeria are being overworked because of the level of corruption. For example, when the pension fund scam broke out, the workers in Nigeria had to work 23 hours every day from Monday till Sunday. 23 hours every day for 7 days. So that means they were only getting 1 hour of sleep every day just to keep up with the corruption data. And then just when they were about to, you know, relax, just when they were like, finally, we got everything under control, bam, the subsidy scam broke out. And the Security Exchange Commission scam. So Transparency International said they had to take their workers from the remaining 199 countries just to go to, you know, the Nigerian desk and try to work with the corruption data in Nigeria. And they're saying that even the staff from the 200 countries are inefficient to deal with the corruption rate. That's like 600 workers unable to tackle the corruption rate in one country. Bad now. And what that means is that they have no staff to work on the remaining 199 countries, because all 600 of them are working just on Nigeria. So they wrote this nasty letter to the president of Nigeria, and I want to read a little bit of it to you. There appears to be a conspiracy on the part of your country's political class to overwhelm Transparency International and thereby make it impossible for her to work and release the 2012 Corruption Perceptions Index. Wow, can you imagine? Now they're telling the president, Your Excellency, we are hoping that you would be willing to discuss a negotiated settlement. I wonder what that can be. You know, Transparency International is seeking compensation from Nigeria for the unprecedented disruption of her work occasioned by your gargantuan I'm guessing a Nigerian person has to do with this tea, because when I hear big English, I know Nigerians are talking. Occasioned by your gargantuan corruption scams this year, which has made it impossible to focus on any other country. Now, the last part that I want to read for you is, if you're unwilling to negotiate, we have been instructed to institute legal action against your country. What? Are they going to sue Nigeria? For conspiracy to derail the work of a credible international organization by overwhelming her with corruption data and stretching her resources beyond tolerable human limits. That's very funny, which is why I don't know if Transparency International actually wrote the data, but if they did, what a shame, what a shame. It's just something for our leaders to think about, you know, just keeping it real. A Nollywood star just got married in Paris, Stephanie Okereke. The wedding was beautiful. I thought you guys should see it.
Like to say this after me.
I, Linus Idahosa,
do take you,
Stephanie Onyekachi Okereke.
With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
Amen.
Look at that apprehension. Stephanie is shaking.
Ladies and gentlemen, I pronounce them man and wife. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. You may kiss your bride. It's okay.
Y'all, it's been real, and I'm keeping it real right up in here. Until next week, I'ma see y'all later. Peace out.